for a cancer patient, the two worst things are, number one, the diagnosis of having a cancer. Number two, knowing that you need treatment and that the drug or the treatment that you need is unavailable to you. I was diagnosed with stage 3 prostate cancer. I was operated, had radiotherapy. For a few years, we thought the cancer had gone, but it came back. It metastasized to different parts of my body. My last tests are showing that after 3 years of hormone therapy, the cancer is coming back. So that's not good news.
Patients can come in with a high PSA level or some symptoms that are suspicious of cancer, but ultimately the urologist will be responsible of doing the biopsy. And then once the diagnosis is made, we have to know if the patient has localized prostate cancer or if, unfortunately, it's already spread outside of the prostate. Patients with disseminated prostate cancer, then we have to go with hormonally based therapy. And when that doesn't work anymore, then usually we'll go on to chemotherapy.
Metastatic prostate cancer is very difficult to cure, even with chemo.
Up to now, we had three main options when it came to cancer treatment. We had surgery, we had chemotherapy, and we had external radiation. Now, we're adding a fourth treatment, which is radioligand therapy, or RLT.
In nuclear medicine, we combine radioactive atoms. These atoms, they allow us to either image or treat any process. And to target that process, we use molecules or pharmaceuticals. We use PSMA. PSMA stands for prostate-specific membrane antigen, which has been discovered to bind a lot to prostate cancer cells. So therefore, what we're able to do in nuclear medicine is to use an imaging atom, combine it with PSMA, and image very accurately prostate cancer. And then you change this imaging atom into a treatment atom.
Now we are able to use the same tracer at the IR level to treat the lesion.
The basic principle behind RLT is we look at a cancer cell and we find some receptor or protein that's specific to the cancer cell. Once we have decided on a target, in the lab, we're going to design a molecule that binds to this target. And on this molecule, we're going to stick a radioactive substance.
It's a target therapy. So you don't attack the normal cell on a patient because prostate cancer is a systemic cancer.
Past a certain point, the cancer will spread to multiple organs. There's little clusters of cancerous cells that are all over the body. With RLT, we're injecting the treatment in the bloodstream. It's gonna travel all over the body. So it's gonna go and look for all these little clusters of cancerous cells all over, and it's gonna deliver the radiation directly in those while doing limited damage to the healthy cells that are everywhere else.
A patient comes in pre-therapy, they're on regular opiates. And then when you see them after only one cycle, you see their biomarkers that represent the amount of prostate cancer that's in their body go, for example, from 10 to 1. And they're like, yeah, I've been, you know, decreasing the amount of morphine I take every day. I've been feeling a bit better. I'm moving better. We're giving patients not only more time, but more time with good quality of life.
This is not going to replace surgery, chemotherapy, and radiation therapy, but it's going to play a complementary role. It's going to be something new that you get in addition. It's a new option.
Deciding on when it's appropriate to give radioligand therapy, we have to base it on the clinical research that has proven where it's efficacious. It was first studied in the worst case scenarios, patients that basically have exhausted the life prolonging therapies that are available, like hormonally based therapy, and then have progressed after chemotherapy. And here we see that radioligand therapy is better tolerated and it delays the progression of the disease.
We had a patient come in and he tells us he wants to attend his daughter's wedding, but he wasn't sure he could. We administered him lutetium PSMA. He had an initial excellent response, and was actually able to attend in health his daughter's wedding. The opportunity we gave him, the possibility of attending his daughter's wedding, is invaluable. These are patients who have failed all lines of therapy, and they come to us and we're giving them this extra hope.
Over the next few years and decades, there's going to be new RLT treatments that are approved, including breast cancer, lung cancer. Thousands of Canadian patients will benefit from this technology over the coming years. Access right now in Canada is a bit patchy. It was first approved by Health Canada in October 2022.
It's now available in Ontario, Alberta, and Nova Scotia, but not in Quebec.
We still don't have reimbursement for this drug at a provincial level. We know actual patients who would have been eligible for this treatment in late 2022 or early 2023. And some of these patients, they've passed away in the meantime. It's not because we didn't have the medical capacity to do it. It was just because there were administrative roadblocks and we didn't have reimbursement at the provincial level.
Some people from different government think it's very expensive, but at the end, it's not more expensive, it's cheaper, because we treat those patients as an outpatient, we prolong the life. The patient has a normal life.
It's difficult enough to have to live with cancer, but to have to fight, and my doctors are saying it's not available right now. It's coming. It's soon. A lot of patients need it now.
If I see a patient with a prostate cancer that would benefit from a treatment that exists and is available for the patient, how can I tell him that, well, because we have not come to an agreement, you don't have access to this type of treatment? This is almost impossible to say to a patient, and some of those patients are young.
What's even more hurtful is that this therapy is given elsewhere. In the United States, where I did some of my training, they were routinely giving it. They were building their experience with it, and patients were having access to this medication.
We are very ready to offer those treatments. As soon as we get the green light from the government and the reimbursement, we're going to be able to start treating patients tomorrow.
If I were living in Ontario right now, I'd have access to this program. Some people have asked me, have you thought of moving to Ontario? Think about that. I'm a proud Canadian. I'm also a proud Quebecer. I've always had the impression that universal healthcare is a right for all Canadians.
To know that they could access this treatment tomorrow, but they cannot for administrative reasons, that's just a shame.
I think we have to discuss and work with the government. Show them that this technology is available in some countries. Like in the United States, you have about 1,000 patients who have prostate cancer who are treated each week. And even here in Canada, we have three provinces at the moment who are offering this type of treatment, like Ontario, Alberta, and Nova Scotia.
We need more options for these patients that are unfortunately destined to die of prostate cancer.
There's no reason that we should be holding back this treatment. Holding back a treatment like this is putting a stop to cancer research.
This is just version 1.0. Research is happening to try to target all types of cancers with such therapies.
What we are discussing at the moment, maybe in a year time, we'll have the breast cancer, we'll have the oncologic cancer of the colon, for example.
And this is why it's extremely important to get into the game as early as possible, because if we don't, we won't have the essential experience to be able to use these other compounds that are going to be more performant, targeting more types of cancers.
This treatment is the last hope for cancer patients right now.
In our institution at the CHUM, we have ample experience with lutetium PSMA. We're ready to give this widely, but we have to think about the community. We need to give access to this treatment to everyone, wherever they live.
But I'm very positive, and I think we should keep talking together with the patient, the people from the government, the specialists in this field, and we will come to, I'm pretty sure, to an agreement that all Canadians will have the same accessibility to this kind of treatment.
My hope is to go into remission someday. It's the hope of all cancer patients to be able to live a normal life where you're not waiting for this verdict, how much time you have left. I'm fighting for time here. For me and for all men in Quebec and in Canada where the drug is not yet available. To cancer patients who are living with prostate cancer right now and who are desperately waiting for this treatment, keep hope, keep fighting any way you can. Call government officials. I will keep putting pressure on. I will keep fighting to my last breath for this to be made available to all patients in Quebec and in Canada who desperately need it. So good luck to everybody.